Welcome to the PowerPanel Battery Management Setting Tutorial. In this video, you will learn how to perform initial setup, which includes setting up general information, UPS list, VM list, threshold, and email settings. Through initial setup, you will be able to edit your account information, set up the UPS and VM list, configure the threshold settings, and manage the email server and receivers. After logging in, you can change the username and password, and select the preferred temperature unit. In the menu panel, click Settings to open the drop-down menu, and then select General. Enter the username you prefer. Enter the current password. Enter the new password. Enter the new password again to confirm. Click Save to save the changes. The username, displayed on the bottom left corner, will be updated accordingly. You can also change the preferred temperature unit by selecting from the drop-down list and click Save. The temperature information of the system will be displayed with the selected unit. PowerPanel Battery Management allows you to monitor your battery system by group of BM or by group of UPS. The first step is to manually add the UPS to the system. In the menu panel, click Settings to open the drop-down menu, and then select UPS list. Click Add to add a UPS. Name the UPS. Enter the model name of the UPS. Enter the power rating. Current rating and voltage rating of the UPS. Assign a manager to the UPS and describe the location of the UPS. Click Add, and the UPS is added and listed in the table. There are two ways to add a BM to the system. One is through Add, to add one BM at a time. The other is through IP range, to add multiple BMs at once. In the menu panel, click Settings to open the drop-down menu, and then select BM. Click Add. Enter the IP address of the specific BM. And click Add to search. When the BM is found, it will be listed in the table. Follow the same procedures to add all the BMs to the system. To search by the IP range, click IP range and enter the IP range, then click Scan to add the BM within the IP range to the system. Click the triangle next to the BM to view the string information. Click the settings icon to edit the information of the BM. Name the BM. Check the number of strings and number of batteries using on a string. Turn equalization feature on or off. Select the impedance measuring interval. Assign a manager. And describe the location of the BM. If the battery strings are connected to a UPS in the system, select the UPS from the drop-down list to pair them. Click Save to save the settings. Once the UPS and BM are added to the system and the pairing is configured, you can monitor the battery status on the dashboard page by group of BM or by group of UPS. Moreover, if there are Enviro sensors connecting to the BM, the Enviro sensor panel will be displayed. Click the left or right arrow to switch to information of different Enviro sensors. You can also check the Enviro sensor list by clicking Enviro sensor to open the drop-down menu and select status. To configure the settings of the Enviro sensor, click Settings and select Enviro sensor. Then, click the Settings icon to open the setting page of the selected Enviro sensor. PowerPanel battery management allows you to set the upper and lower bound values of the battery parameters for monitoring the system status. In the menu panel, click Settings to open the drop-down menu and then select Threshold. Select the BM and the string whose threshold setting you would like to configure. Select the parameter for which you would like to set the threshold. You can type or use the up and down arrows to enter the upper and lower bound values. The threshold setting and current measurements of the system will be displayed in the graphic on the right side. Click Save to save the settings. If you are setting the threshold for impedance, it can be applied to a specific battery you select, and the values can be set on an absolute or relative basis. PowerPanel battery management supports email notifications, and you can manage the email server and receivers who will receive the regular reports and alert notifications. In the menu panel, click Settings to open the drop-down menu and then select Email. If you select Generic to use the SMTP as mail server, you have to enter the server name and sender. Select the security type. Enter the port number, account, and password. Click Save to save the server setting. If you select Gmail as the mail server, click Login to log in to the Gmail account that will be used as the email sender. To manage the receivers of the report and alert notification, click Add. Enter the name and email address of the receiver. Decide the email type that will be sent to the receiver. Click Save to add the receiver to the list. Now, the initial setup is complete.